In this video, it's all about long division. Long division is a way to break down a big division problem into a few smaller, easier steps. When numbers get too big to divide in your head, we use something called long division. And before we begin, long division symbol has some essential parts you need to know first. The dividend is the number that's inside the bracket. It's the number we're going to divide up. The divisor is the number that's written outside on the left. It tells us how many groups we're dividing into. And finally, the quotient is the answer to the division problem. As we solve, we write each digit of the quotient on top, right above the dividend. We won't really know what that means until we put it into practice. And here is our first example. In this case, we put the 642 inside the long division symbol. And we place the 3 outside, since it is the divisor. Since the dividend is too big, we can't divide all the digits at once. Instead, we have to go digit by digit. And side note, we always work it from left to right. That's cool, because it makes the digits smaller and easier for us to divide. Let's start with the first digit, which is 6. We ask, how many times does 3 go into 6? That's simple. 3 goes into 6 2 times. So we write the 2 on top, above the 6. After that, we multiply that 2. 2 times 3 equals 6. We write that 6 under the original 6. Our next move is to subtract. 6 minus 6 equals 0. And we're not done yet, since there are still other numbers. We bring down the next digit, 4, to team up with the 0. Now we're working with 4. We're going to repeat the same steps we just did. We ask, how many times does 3 go into 4? Just once. So we place 1 on top. But wait, I know what some of you might be thinking. If we divide 4 by 3, shouldn't there be a remainder? Yep, there would be. But for now, we're not focusing on remainders. And that's totally okay. Then we multiply. 1 times 3 equals 3. Subtract. 4 minus 3 equals 1. Now we bring down the last number 2 to team up with the 1. Now we have 12. We ask, how many times does 3 go into 12? That's 4 times. So we place 4 on top. Then we multiply. 4 times 3 equals 12. Subtract. 12 minus 12 equals 0. And we're done, we're done. It might seem like a lot of work, but actually, it saves us a lot of time, especially compared to counting on our fingers, to figure out how many times 3 goes into 642. Pretty cool, right? Now we can see that on our quotient part, we have 2-1 for us our final answer. Let's try another one. 250 divided by 4 this time, our answer will come with a remainder. We're dividing 250 by 4, just like before. We put 250 inside the long division symbol. That's the dividend. And we place the 4 outside the bracket. That's the divisor. Now, let's take it step by step, digit by digit. We look at the first digit, which is 2. We ask, how many times does 4 go into 2? It doesn't. 4 is too big for 2. So we write 0 on top, above the 2. Then we move to the next digit, which is 5. And now we're working with 25. Now we ask, how many times does 4 go into 25? It goes 6 times, because 4 times 6 is 24. We write 6 on top, above the 5. Now we multiply. 6 times 4 is 24. Then subtract. 25 minus 24 equals 1. Now we bring down the last digit, which is 0. That gives us 10. Now we ask, How many times does 4 go into 10? It goes 2 times, because 4 times 2 is 8. We write 2 on top, above the 0. Now multiply 2 times 4 is 8. Subtract 10 minus 8 equals 2. Now we've run out of digits, nothing left to bring down. But we still have a little left over, 2. Side note, when we divide and there's a number left at the end, but no more digits to bring down, we call that leftover a remainder. We can't go any further, so we simply leave it as it is and write it at the end of our answer using the letter R, meaning remainder. So when we divide 250 by 4, the answer is 62 remainder 2. Let's try this one. 148 divided by 5, this one will give us a remainder 2. We're dividing 148 by 5. So just like always, we put 148 inside the division symbol that's our dividend. And we place the 5 outside, that's the divisor. Now we'll go digit by digit. We start with the first digit, which is 1. We ask, how many times does 5 go into 1? It doesn't, 5 is too big for 1. So we write 0 on top, then we move to the next digit, which is 4. Working with 14, we ask, how many times does 5 go into 14? It goes 2 times, because 5 times 2 is 10. We write 2 on top, above the 4. Now we multiply, 2 times 5 is 10. Then subtract. 14 minus 10 equals 4. Now bring down the next digit 8, and now we're working with 48. We ask, how many times does 5 go into 48? That's 9 times, because 5 times 9 is 45. We write 9 on top, above the 8. Multiply. 9 times 5 is 45. Subtract. 48 minus 45 equals 3. Now we're out of digits, and we have 3 left over. When we divide, and there's a number left at the end, but no more digits to bring down, we call that left over a remainder. We can't go any further, so we simply leave it as it is and write it at the end of our answer using the letter R, meaning remainder. So when we divide 148 by 5, the answer is 29 remainder 3. And that's it for today's lesson on long division.